early to go to church. And it's really exciting because when I wake up, I feel the spirit that is always with me. My name is Maciel Gutierrez. I love being a Mormon because it's something that I really feel like is true.
My name is Vanessa Gutierrez. I was born in the Dominican Republic. I came to New York when I was like 6 years old, and I never went back. When we joined, the missionary was going down the block, and the missionary was like, oh, I have a strong feeling we should go that way, and they wasn't supposed to go that way. My sister started asking them questions, and they came to the house, and they baptized us. When I went to church, I prayed, and I know it's true, because my heart tells me.
On Sunday, I pick myself up in the morning and go to church by myself. I don't go with anybody.
My name is Wendy Lee. My family and I moved to New York about 4 years ago. I decided to join the LDS religion when I was 16 years old because I was seeking something. I never thought that I would join a religion, but I feel like it contains so much truth in it, so I just decided to join. I go to an international high school, and there's students from all over the world. But my brother and I are the only LDS people in the whole school, which is really, really hard.
My name is Sarita, and I live in the Bronx. I live with my mother and my younger sister, but she's bigger than me though. And I go to a Catholic school, because the public schools in New York are not the best. Me and my sister are the only LDS people in the whole school.
Sarita don't have a lot of friends because out here, a lot of the kids Sarita's age, they want you to be bad a little bit. And Sarita don't want to be bad at all. And it takes a lot being that age and not having a lot of friends.
I keep myself distant just not to have conflict. I have to read my scriptures every day. I have to because I just won't be alive. Everything about the church makes me happy. It's like there's a hand right in my hand whenever I'm by myself. I think about it sometimes too, just like, how come I'm not sad right now? People are outside, my sister's outside, and I'm at home reading church books.
These young women stand alone. I would say 99% of them don't have any parents to say you need to go to church today. They do it because they want to, and they do it because they believe the principles and the values that church stands for. And I think that's what makes them really, really unique, is that it comes from inside of them.
It's not easy, especially when I don't have a job and I have to pay Metro card fares.
Since a lot of them can't afford a subway card, it's a 45-minute walk. And a lot of their parents don't want them walking around because there are shootings in the neighborhoods. There are drug dealers on all the corners, and many times it's their brothers, or their uncles, or their friends, or kids they grew up with. So I've met several. They're really trying hard to be good Latter-day Saints, read their scriptures, pray, and do what Heavenly Father would want them to do, but they've never seen anybody else do it. And it's like they're making it up as they go along.
The classes today were awesome. It's like, I don't know, I'm just not having fun today. Like, I'm just a little bit bored, I guess. It's my own fault, though. I'm not talking to people as much. I'm just shy, I guess. Because over here, you have to be so, like, outgoing. Hi, talking to everybody, but that's not me.
I've been homesick, like, since Monday. We don't feel comfortable. It's like, we don't fit in. That's the only problem. But besides that, the classes are lovely.
Everybody in my team was not interested in talking to me because I was just so shy and, you know, I guess I just seem uninteresting to them. I just felt so miserable. And no one came to me and talked to me and get to know me. So I just felt really left out.
Oh my gosh, it's gonna be so cool, but nervous.
I was so nervous because there were still some steps we didn't know.
I was nervous because I never saw so many people looking at me. I just looked at my left and my right, and it was my girls. So it was like, oh, let's just have fun. Let's just show them how we are. Going crazy, like clapping and being happy for the performance.
They thought we did so good. I was like, really? Did you see that? Are you sure?
Everybody loved it so much. They were like, oh, it was so good. It was so good.
They were so good at salsa dancing. It was just so much fun to watch them.
After we did that dance, a lot of people was like, oh, you gotta teach me how to dance. I just felt, whoo, these people love us.
You know, love our culture, our moves, our dance, everything. So I just felt more proud to be a Latina. I think I learned a little bit more about like my culture, and I think I like it.
We're gonna talk about the Holy Ghost and how it can help us find our personal mission in life.
We taught the girls, the younger girls, a lesson. Like, we were all supposed to teach them. And it was the most beautiful experience. I love it.
It is important to have the Holy Ghost with us, and it's a beautiful gift that God has given us. And it's hard to listen to the Holy Ghost when it's saying, like, don't do that. But if it's right, you can feel it in your heart.
I just remember they were, like, glowing when they were talking about their feelings and the church and how it touched their lives and how it made their life so much better and different and special, and I admired that.
When you fast, I think it's easier to feel the spirit because, you know, your body's clean, and I don't know, I think it's easier because that's how I feel. When we fast, I feel the spirit so strongly, so it's really good to fast.
I felt it was beautiful just sharing my, you know, my feelings for the church and my testimony, and I love it. I love that.
My favorite thing about EFY was when we went to the auditorium, when we sang together. I love that.
When we sang As Sisterz In Zion, I felt the Spirit very strongly, that we're all daughters of God and our race doesn't matter.
The thing that really changed me inside was how you felt the Spirit with those kind of people, you know. It's like, no, this is beautiful. I'm missing out if I don't just open up my mind and just get to know them better.
I was just very shy and very, very silent most of the time. And I felt like I just could not be myself. I didn't have the courage. So I just prayed sincerely to Heavenly Father to help me to have the ability to express myself to people in my group. And that's how I got the courage to opening myself up to other people. As children.